Genuinely though, I really did love the film. I thought it was really, really cool. I was wondering, you know, obviously you're coming from a background in stop motion animation, and I presume that's the kind of thing where it's very much on rails, and it's there's no room for improvisation. Mm-hmm. Was that the case for this? Like, I mean, did you find that shift?
Yeah, the shift was challenging at times, but it wasn't necessarily as challenging as I thought it might be. You know, working in stop motion and in CG animation for the last 20 years. There are definitely analogs to the experience. The processes are similar on some level. I mean, they're different in a lot of ways. But there is an improvisational quality to stop motion specifically. I mean, it's very methodical. It's very disciplined. You have to think everything out. But oftentimes, when you're dealing with a physical object, things don't go the way you'd expect. And you have to be willing to shift gears, sometimes midstream.
Yeah.
Mixing metaphors. But it's... I knew there was going to be an aspect of this film that I was going to be very comfortable with, which was the robot performance, bringing this character to life. Because as an animator, that's what you do. You imbue life into something that doesn't have any. You give something personality and character and life that is an inanimate thing. Mm-hmm. And that was one of the tricks, one of the challenges to make this film work, is that people had to believe Bumblebee as a real and emotional creature. And at the same time, the other part of the trick was the actors had to give a great and emotional performance to something that wasn't there. And I was blessed to have Hailee Steinfeld and John Cena in the film who could do that.
Yeah. The tone, I think, was really sweet. Like, and I think it came about quite naturally, I think. You know, the fact, like you were saying, the idea of, like, Hailee Steinfeld, the fact that she has to emote to literally a tennis ball.
Yeah.
But when you were putting it together in the edit room, I mean, like, what was your kind of thinking there? Like, I mean, was there parts of it that you felt, okay, this is too dark, I need to cut that? Was there anything like that in it?
Yeah, I mean, it's always right trying to find the right balance.
Yeah.
In everything I've done, and, you know, my philosophy at everything I've done at Leica was to try to find an artful balance of darkness and light, of intensity and warmth, of humor and heart, of, you know, something that has a thinking brain and a strong, you know, beating heart behind it. And that was the case here. It's, you know, you're always calibrating. You'll try different things, you'll play around, and sometimes you find you go too far and you got to throttle back. And so that is part of, you know, the difference. One of the big differences in live action is that part of the process happens at the end as you're you know, in the edit bay, and it's a reductive process where you have this wealth of material and you're trying to shape it in that way. And in stop motion animation, that's at the beginning because you storyboard and cut everything together at the front.
And it's rigorous.
It is. It's very disciplined. So that was essentially it was reversed.
Yeah. The challenges of this, I mean, has it made you, I don't want to say gun shy about directing live action again? I mean, do you foresee yourself doing live action?
Oh, I'm not gun shy at all. You know, having gotten through the process and realized I survived and I learned a bunch of stuff and I have a whole new bag of tricks that I can apply to animation or anything that I do. That's what creative people long for on some level, is just new and different kinds of experiences. And I'd certainly never done anything like this before. And that, you know, that's exciting. That means I have new skills that I can apply to anything that I do moving forward.
Yeah. Final question. If there was to be a sequel, would you come back?
That's a big if.
Yeah.
I mean, I made sure that I designed this film as if it was a standalone thing,
right,
that it doesn't presuppose anything that happens before or after. This is a film. This is a complete story, and it explores a very important part of these characters' lives. You know, in my brain, I can imagine where their adventures go from here, but I didn't intend to just, you know, to leave it open. It's self-contained. You know, if the audience, you know, loves the material, if they scream and holler and say that they want more, we'd be fools to not listen.
Sure.
But I didn't look at it that way. And, you know, hopefully people do like it. Hopefully they are clamoring for a sequel, but that's up to the world.
That's really cool. Okay, we're going to leave it there.
All right.
They're calling an army.
I've seen firsthand these things really are.
Bumblebee, there is only one way to end this war. You must protect Earth and its people.
Take it down!
My back, B!
How we stop them. You've got me. And I'm not going anywhere.